Rudaker is, contrary to what the name suggests, a large city. If Rodario is to be believed, more than 70,000 people live here, a number that you find it hard to even imagine. But while you walk through the streets, you don't doubt that it's the truth. Never before have you seen such huge masses of people.
If we are looking for somewhere to quench our thirst or for a roof over our heads, then I would recommend the Golden Well Tavern. And we can find everything we need for the rest of our journey at the Big Market. Just say where you want to go, Tungdil, and I'll show you the way.
You follow Rodario through the lively streets until he reaches a run-down two-story building. You hope that this dump isn't the tavern that Rodario recommends. You prepare yourself for the worst. But the inside of the tavern surprises you all. The walls are clad with dark, finely ornamented wood. The floor is clean, the tables are weighed down with good food, and a hot fire is burning in the fireplace. One should never judge a book by its cover. The guests look you over, full of curiosity, and many nod a greeting. The haggard woman behind the bar greets you loudly.
Rodario, you old rogue! What are you doing here? And you've got dwarves with you! I don't see one my whole life, and then several come along in the same month.
We are on an important mission, Madame Flory, and could do with a place to stay the night.
Rodario introduces you and negotiates a good price for a few beds and a night's lodgings.
Sorry for asking, but you said you'd seen some other dwarves recently.
You're thinking of Gandagar's group and wonder whether they might have reached the kingdom of the Fifthlings already.
Yes, a nice bloke from the west paid for his room for a month in advance and then disappeared.
Travelling light.
The landlady's expression darkens.
That was 3 weeks ago. If he doesn't come back soon, I'll have to release the room.
You give Namora a sign and sneak onto the first floor. The half-elf appears moments later. To your surprise, she has Balandis with her, who must have caught something of what was said.
I want to know who the dwarf who is sneaking around here is. Perhaps he belongs to Gandagar's group.
After apologizing to various guests for intruding, you are left with just one untried door. Namora picks the lock and you enter the room unseen. The room is bigger than all the rooms in the tavern you have seen so far, and all just for one guest. There are maps, various pieces of notepaper, and 3 notebooks on the table. The notes are partly written in Dwarvish and partly in the language of humans. The 3 of you scan through them until Balandis draws your attention to a map on which the route from the Kingdom of the Firstlings to the Kingdom of the Fifthlings is marked.
What would make a Firstling travel to the Perished Land, or even to the Kingdom of the Fifthlings?
You believe you've found an explanation.
Here, this letter. I have found a way, but I don't know if I will return safely with Star Slasher. That's why I leave to you, dear Barris, my notes, may you, and so on.
Star Slasher?
You have come across this name in the notes a few times already, but you just shrug your shoulders and throw the letter back onto the table in disappointment. You had hoped to have found out some news on the whereabouts of the other group.
A sword. Apparently it was given to Giselbert Ironeye by a caravan travelling from the other lands. It seems we're dealing with a treasure hunter.
The big market at the city's south gate certainly lives up to its name. You have never seen a market on such a scale. Stands, large and small, as far as the eye can see. Everything you could possibly need can be found here, as well as plenty of things that seem to have no use at all. While you push your way through the crowd to get to the trader Rodario wants to introduce to you, you overhear 2 peasants talking about elves.
No, I tell you, it was elves. Pale skin, pointy ears.
Yeah, something strange is going on these days. Old Trundlewood from down Acrehill way said he saw some pointy ears too. Come to think of it, where's he been all week?
Here we are.
Rodario's sudden announcement draws your attention away from the locals to the tent that you're now standing in front of.
Welcome to Brand's Potpourri.
Whatever your heart may desire, I can supply.
You are woken with a jolt in the middle of the night by a blood-curdling scream. You look around in panic and see that the others have been woken too. But only Geralda has beads of sweat on her brow. She's breathing heavily. Concerned, you go over to her.
I can remember. The Alfar. They are doing experiments on the children of the Smith. We have to save them.
Alpha? Experiments? What are you talking about?
I can remember everything. Or at least some of it. I know that I was taken prisoner by the Alpha, along with other dwarfs. They experimented on us, and I somehow escaped.
Where was this exactly?
They are here, nearby. It was a village, I think.
An Alfar village in Tabayin doesn't sound very likely.
By Vrakus, if the Alfar are experimenting on dwarves, we can't just ignore it. We have to free the prisoners. We can't save the world if we ignore the suffering right in front of our eyes. We will help Geralda.
Boendal and the others accept your decision. Geralda nods at you gratefully. You see before you the edge of the Eternal Forest, the Elven Kingdom of Alandor, in which the last of the Elves live. Since the Alfar invaded Girdlegard with the Orcs, they have hunted their cousins down, banished them, and taken their forests for themselves. You are interested in the Kingdom of the Elves, but it wouldn't be a good idea to enter the forest with dwarves, a half-elf, and whatever Jerun is. When you reach Acrehill, there isn't a single villager in sight. An uneasy feeling creeps over you, which finally turns into certainty when you see red paintings on the walls of the houses.
Alpha.
As expected, you don't find any survivors. But there are also no undead. The Perish Land has not yet advanced this far. You discover some footprints on the northern edge of the village.
It was orcs. Looks as though they waited here while the Point Ears wreaked havoc in the village. It seems like they moved on towards the north.
The pictures painted in blood tell the horrifying story of how the Alfar came to the village and killed the inhabitants. You also find a few elaborately carved bones, some larger ones, like those of humans, some smaller and stronger, like those of dwarves. When you reach the other end of the village, disgust is written in the faces of your companions. None of you says a word. You gather all the bones you can find together and burn them. You wash over the paintings with water from the well. You weren't able to prevent this gruesome incident, but you don't want to leave a single trace of it behind. You walk through the villages that once blossomed, but are now deserted due to the advance of the parish land. The colour has drained away from the wood of many of the houses, just as it has from the countryside itself. A carpet of withered plants rustles and crackles under your feet. You don't know if the parish land can ever be driven away again, and even if it can, it is questionable whether people will ever live here again. You sigh and try to drive these dark thoughts away from your mind. The path to Lake Fire lies in front of you. That is where the dragon Bramboosel is said to have dwelt, before being killed by the Fifthlings, so they could light the Dragonfire Forge with his flames. Rodario sings a song about the dreadful might of the dragon, and you all look down into the flames below with reverence. When you finally turn away, you think you can see a slight look of sorrow in Boindil's face. Sadness at the fact that the dragon has already been defeated by someone else.
Ooh, do you smell that? Come! Oik, oik!
Without even waiting for you, Boindil runs over the hill and disappears behind it. You follow him. And as you reach the brow, you see a very strange scene before you.
You shouldn't touch them.
But I was hungry.
Yes? Good
plan.
Right, then.
Huh? On my way.
Of course! What is it? Ha ha!
Yes?
What is it? Yes?
I didn't even take off my gloves.
Pavrakas!
Vile creature!
Now you've got me interested.
And what now?
I was expecting more of a battle.
The army put up a fight! And again!
What is it?
Yes?
What is it?
What is it?
Now you've got me interested.
Huh?
Yeah! Who's next?
Huh? Yes?
Pavrakas! What is it? He hardly put up a fight! Come here, you!
Attack! And again!
Huh?
What do you need?
This is going to hurt.
Yes. Right away.
Now you've got me interested.
What is it? Huzzah! What is this?
It's good job. What do you need?
Didn't even take off my gloves.
And what now?
Yes?
He hardly put up a fight.
For the firstlings!
What is it? Come here, you! Ha ha!
Huh?
End it!
Yet lost.
Killed.
Creature.
He hardly put up a fight!
What a waste of time. What is it?
What is it?
What is it?
Now you've got me interested.
Yes?
Yes?
He hardly put up a fight!
That was good training!
Vile creature!
Feel my power!
That is it? Makes sense.
Huh?
Pavrakas! Yeah!
Attack! Kill!
What is it?
Yes? Sure!
Who's next?
Good plan.
Now you've got me interested.
It?
What is it?
End it! Attack! And again!
What do you need?
If I have you! But that's a bad idea. Now you've got me interested. Yes.
Yeah!
Understood.
What is it?
Of course!
What is it?
If I have to. What is it? Not a bad idea.
Huh?
Huh? I'm with you! Huzzah!
Yes?
Right away. Now you've got me interested.
What is it? Good plan. Ah! I was expecting more of a battle.
For the firstlings!
And I didn't even take off my gloves. With pleasure.
What do you need?
Fought well and yet lost. Ha!
Right away. I was expecting more
now
of a battle.
Now you've got me interested.
At once.
What is it? Yeah! Yes, yes! Huzzah!
What is it?
For the firstlings!
Fought well and yet lost.
What is it?
That was good training.
Yes?
Right away. Makes sense. I was expecting more of a battle.
For the firstlings!
And what now?
Fought well and yet lost.
Come here, you! Huzzah!
That was good training.
Who's next? I'm with you.
What is it?
Yes. On my way.
Then.
Yes. Good plan.
Favrakis.
Now you've got me interested.
At
not
what?
A bad idea.
Huh?
What do you need?
What is it?
I was expecting more of a battle.
The chaotic battle between the orcs, the undead, and you comes to the best possible conclusion. No one else is standing but you. You decide to have a little look around. The closer you get to the murky pool, the worse it stinks of decay and death. At first, you thought it was only dirty water, but for as much as you can make out through the gloom, it seems almost black and has wondrous streaks. You tremble at the thought that you could end up the same way. You hope that one of your companions would have sympathy with you if you were to die in the Perish Land. You discover a file that looks like the one Geralda carries with her. Before you can get a proper look at it, Geralda is suddenly standing next to you, and she wrenches it out of your hand. She turns it back and forth excitedly, but then disappointment spreads across her face. The container is empty. Without a word, she goes back to examining the surroundings. It's a map of the surroundings. Not far from your current position is a place clearly marked with a red cross. Is it another Orc camp, or even the Alphar camp? You mark the place on your own map. With the probable location of another camp up your sleeve, you continue on your way. Some way from the path, you come across an old campsite between some rocks. A trampled-out campfire and scattered belongings, papers, bottles and a necklace, suggests that the traveller either had to flee in a hurry or was abducted.
That is a firstling necklace. I recognise the emblem. It belongs to the clan of the Roughblades.
We only know of one firstling out so far west these days, the dwarf whose notes we found in the tavern.
Star Slasher. If King Gizzlebert really did wield this sword, it would be an unbelievably valuable artifact. Just imagine if the sword really existed.
It's not worth losing your life for, or, in the worst case, losing your life and then rising again.
You look around again more closely, but there's not much here that could help you. The ground is too hard for footprints, and the objects that have been left behind could have come from any old dwarf trader.
Do you know anything about the Rough Blades, Balandis?
Every firstling knows of the clan. They have a long tradition as weaponsmiths, though their work is often exotic and sometimes thought of as undwarfish. They experiment a lot with blade shapes and hilt lengths. Their weapons are easy to recognise.
Sounds as though someone from a clan like that would definitely be very interested in a legendary sword.
Geralda struggles to keep pace all day, and when you see her struggling, you give the order to set up camp for the night earlier than usual.
Are you all right?
The female dwarf looks ill, and as she's aware of the fact, she doesn't even try to make excuses.
The potion! It's finished! I need more of it!
She looks at you imploringly, as if you could help her. Over the next few days, Geralda's condition grows increasingly worse. She begins to shiver, and more than once you catch her muttering to herself and glancing at Andakai surreptitiously. The Maegar claims she does not know what kind of potion it is and why Geralda might need it. You believe her, but you also notice that Andakai doesn't really seem interested in finding a solution to the problem either. You reach the place that was marked on the orc's map, and judging by the site you are presented with, there is no doubt. This is where the Alfar did their experiments.
Dwarves! Oh, how glad I am to finally see members of my own race again. How glad I am to see anyone at all who doesn't want to kill me.
We're here to save you. We've heard that Alfar are experimenting on dwarves. Where are the others?
I am the last one.
There's me too.
You? Ah, so you escaped? Oh, I should have known it.
You're the firstling who set off into the kingdom of the Fithlings to find the sword Star Slasher, aren't you?
Yes, that's true. Khazdur Roughblade is the name, but how did you know that?
We found your notes in the Golden Well. We were hoping to find you alive.
Ungrateful. I was hoping that someone would find them in the worst case, and that I was successful. I found the sword and was on my way back from the Kingdom of the Fifthlings when the Alfar surprised me. They came in the night, and I had no chance to even defend myself. The next morning, I woke up in this cage. They wanted to do the same to me as they'd done to her.
Khazdur nods in Geralda's direction.
But they didn't get round to that.
How are things in the Grey Range? And what about the Stronghold?
Well, I don't really know.
Khazdur glances at the floor in embarrassment.
I just thought, wouldn't it be good, in this time of great need, if a sword that had belonged to the legendary King Gizzlebert would come into the hands of the Firstlings?
While you are still thinking about what the smith is trying to tell you, Balandis has seen right through him.
You never went to the Fithlings, Khazda Roughblade. You laid false tracks, spent a few days here in the wilderness, and hoped to fob off the Firstlings with one of your swords.
Not for my own benefit. I would have handed it over to Queen Xamtis, a symbol to signify how we should ally with the other dwarf kingdoms, just as it was in Giselbert's time.
I understand. Then you'll be happy to hear the dwarves have formed an alliance without the need for counterfeit swords. You and Geralda, you know each other?
She was already here when I arrived. The Alpha did experiments on her. They fed her with a tincture from this device, and then it was as if she was... as if she was a doll. She had to follow their orders. They trained her in battle, and she could... she could do Alpha magic. I swear it. But the last time, something was different. She fought against the orders of the Alpha, beheaded one of them in the end. She set me and the other prisoners free and ran away in the chaos. The Alpha recaptured all of us, apart from her.
Where are the Alpha? Oh, forget it.
What is it? Over
on my
there?
Way. Huh? Huh?
Hmm? If I have to.
What is it? Huzzah!
What is it?
Yes? Hmm? Geralda!
Yes? Vavrakis! Attack! End it, huh?
Hmm? All right, then.
Yes?
Uh-huh.
Attack! What is it? Come here, you! Vile creature! Killed! Of course! Yes, yes!
What is it? Not a bad idea. Then.
Yes? As good as
what
dawn!
Is it? Not a bad idea.
And again!
This is going to hurt. Hmm?
Your death is on its way!
And what now?
Huh? On my way.
What a waste of time.
Yes?
Now you've got me interested.
What is it? Over there?
Huh? Huh? End
Huzzah!
It!
Huzzah! Fire creature!
Yes?
What is it? Yes, yes! Come here, you!
What is it? Feel my power!
Huh? At once.
What is it? death is on its way!
Now you've got me interested. With pleasure.
Disappointing.
Yeah!
And I didn't even take off my gloves.
Come here, you!
What is it? Not a bad idea.
He hardly put up a fight! Yes. Attack! What is it? Yes, yes!
I'm on it!
Now you've got me interested. Then. What is it?
I'm with you.
If I have to.
On my way.
What is it?
Yes?
Yes? I'm on it. Over there?
Now you've got me interested. All right, then.
Huzzah! I'm with you!
Yes, at once.
What is it? Ha-ha! Come here, you! Of course! Ha-ha!
Understood. For Vrakus!
As good as dawn!
And again!
Your death is on its way!
Put up a fight!
As good as dawn! Die!
Ha-ha! And what now?
What is it? Not a bad idea. All right, then.
He hardly put up a fight!
Yes?
Yes?
Attack! Yeah! And what
I'm
now?
For Vrakus! On my way.
Now you've got me interested. Not a bad idea.
Die!
Feel my power!
And what now? Of course! Huzzah! Ha-ha!
No chance. What a waste of time. No chance.
Yes? At once.
End it.
Understood.
What a waste of time.
Attack!
And I didn't even take off my gloves. Hmm?
Yes, understood. End it!
Huh?
What is it? Yes!
And again! I was hoping never to see a single Shadowmare again after Greenglade.
Good job! There was two of them then! Ha!
Let's have a look around. Maybe there are more survivors, or we might find out something about the potion that Geralda needs. Danger is over, once and for all.
Now the horror finally comes to an end.
A rucksack containing everything needed for a few days in the wilderness and an exotic-looking sword. A rucksack.
They must be some of the missing villagers.
You wonder whether the Alfar killed them for fun or through their experiments. You hope that they didn't suffer for long, even though you know better. Even without having any knowledge of these things, you recognize a laboratory similar to the ones you saw in Lot Yonan's vaults. Only this laboratory seems to be portable, so that it could be taken with you on journeys. The containers are filled with blood, but it seems thinner and smells sweeter than it should. Presumably, the Alfar have done something with it, either for their potions or to use it as paint. Even without having... The elf has been beheaded. He is dead. And even the perished land won't be able to make him rise again.
Well, that's him. I remember now. He forced me to drink a potion. That's what gave me my powers. I killed him and ran away.
On closer inspection, you see a small rolled-up note in the elf's hand.
A recipe. If I had to guess, probably for Geralda's potion.
You have no idea what to do with the various devices and ingredients, but it should be easy for Andekai, as an experienced mager and alchemist, to brew Geralda's potion. You don't wish to spend the night amongst the dead, so you set up camp a little way off. You decipher the recipe for Geralda's potion, together with Andekai and Nemora.
All in all, the equipment and the process is not hard to understand, despite being a little strange. And the ingredients take some getting used to, even for me. This black water and elf blood, for example.
Is this what gives Geralda her powers?
Andekai nods.
It gives her powers and makes her dangerous. What will she do if the potion runs out and she is driven to madness by thirst? She could force me to brew more and more of the potion for her and find a way to supply the elf blood that is needed for it.
Andekai's gaze pierces you.
I can mix a poison that looks just like her potion. She trusts you, Tungdil. If you give it to her, she will drink it, and we will remove an uncontrollable danger from Girdlegard.
That would still be murder. No matter how great a danger she may present, she didn't choose her powers and deserves to live.
Andekai shakes her head in disappointment, but to your surprise, gets to work without another word. After 2 hours, Andekai comes to you and holds out 2 phials that look exactly like Geralda's.
I stick by my opinion, Tungdil. You must recognize how great the danger is. The phial on the left is the potion. In the other is the poison.
Andekai gives you the 2 phials.
Decide wisely.
Before you can say anything, she has already turned away and is marching at a swift pace towards Jerun.
Tungdil, is the potion ready?
You only just managed to hide the phials from Geralda.
Yes, here is the potion.
You give Geralda the real potion, and she takes several large swigs.
Thank you, Tungdil. What would I do without... What is that? It's burning! You've poisoned me!
You stare at the 2nd phial in your hand, and then at the face of the dwarf, contorted in pain. With a final pain-stricken scream, Geralda collapses in front of you. As the others rush over, you are still standing there, frozen in shock.
She's dead. Take her away.
Without worrying about the objections of the others, Jerun follows her order, Andukai grabs your shoulder and pulls you aside.
So you gave her the potion? I thought you would.
You swapped them, how could you?
You feel deceived, and anger boils inside you.
Be aware of who you're talking to, Tungdil Goldhand. We may be travelling together, but I am still one of the six. I have ruled over my realm for many years and made many difficult decisions. This was not one of them. She was a product of Alpha experiments and could have become as great a danger to Girdlegard as not on.
But perhaps we could have...
You think you can see a hint of sympathy in the Maegar's face, but without another word, she leaves you where you're standing. For the first time in a long while, you feel just like the stupid, naive smith who left the cozy vaults in Yonandar so long ago. You have no idea. You don't wish to spend the night amongst the dead. So you set up
all in all.
Is this what?
You can't bring yourself to say it, but you have to agree with the Maegar. You glance at the floor, and a brief nod follows.
And we should destroy the recipe. This should never happen again.
Without another word, Andukai gets to work. After 2 hours, the Maegar is finished and comes to you. She's carrying two files that look just like the one Geralda has.
The file on the right is the potion. The one on the left is the poison.
Andukai gives you the two files.
Decide wisely.
Before you can say anything, she has already turned away and is marching at a swift pace towards Jerun.
Tungdil, is the potion ready?
You only just managed to hide the files from Geralda.
Sure, here's the potion. We followed the recipe to the word.
You pass Geralda the poison. She takes it with thanks, opens the lid, and takes several greedy swigs.
Thank you, Tungdil. What would I do without... What is that? It's burning! You've poisoned me!
I'm sorry. There's no other choice. You are too much of a danger.
You're just like the others! I curse you! Oh.
With a last pained scream, Geralda collapses in front of you. When the others come, you leave them to wonder what has happened. Did you do the right thing?
She's dead. Take her away.
Jerun follows Andukai's orders immediately. The Maegar takes you by the shoulder and pulls you aside.
Good decision, Tungdil. One has to be able to make tough decisions as a leader, and you have done so today.
You have no... You don't wish to spend
all in...
Is this what...
Andukai's gaze pierces you.
I can...
That would still be murder.
After...
Tungdil.
Sure, here's the potion. We followed the recipe to the word.
You pass Geralda the poison. She takes it with thanks, opens the lid, and takes several greedy swigs.
Thank you, Tongdil. What would I do without you?
The poison appears to have no effect on Geralda. Did Andakai make a mistake? Or have you given her the wrong file?
Good night, Tongdil.
You nod, and then she retires. Before you can think about what has just happened, someone grabs your shoulder.
So you gave her the poison after all. It would seem I misjudged you. I shouldn't have swapped the files.
You swapped them? You were trying to trick me!
Be aware of who you're talking to, Tongdil Goldhand. We may be traveling together, but I am still one of the six. I have ruled over my realm for many years and made many difficult decisions. This was not one of them. She was a product of Alpha experiments and could have become as great a danger to Girdlegard as not on. She must die, Tongdil. She is too dangerous, not only for this group, but for the whole of Girdlegard.
You leave the Maegar with a cold glance and go and lie down, but sleep evades you. The next morning, you are the first to get up after a short night, and you go straight to talk to Geralda. Instead of the dwarf, you find a letter under a stone where she'd been sleeping. I overheard you and the Maegar. I did not wish for what has befallen me. I can't help it. That's why I won't let myself be killed for it. Maybe we will meet again one day. Farewell, and look after yourself, Geralda. You put the letter into your pocket pensively. She has escaped. You don't wish to spend
all is this
and you can't bring yourself to say it, but you have to agree with the Maegar. You glance at the floor, and a brief nod follows.
And we should destroy the recipe. This should never happen again.
Without another word, Andakai gets to work. After 2 hours, the Maegar is finished and comes to you. She is carrying two files that look just like the one Geralda has.
The file on the right is the potion. The one on the left is the poison.
Andakai gives you the two files.
Decide wisely.
Before you can say anything, she has already turned away and is marching at a swift pace towards Jerun.
Tongdil, is the potion ready?
You only just managed to hide the files from Geralda.
Yes, here is the potion.
You give Geralda the real potion, and she takes several large swigs.
Thank you, Tongdil. What would I do without you?
Don't mention it. Good night, Geralda.
She nods and leaves. But before you can do the same, someone grabs your shoulder.
You gave her the wrong file.
You stick out your chin.
I clearly haven't. She's alive. You can't trick me so easily.
She must die, Tongdil. She is too dangerous, not only for this group, but for the whole of Girdlegard.
You leave the Maegar with a cold glance and go and lie down, but sleep evades you. The next morning, you are the first to get up after a short night, and you go straight to talk to Geralda. Instead of the dwarf, you find a letter under a stone where she'd been sleeping. I overheard you and the Maegar. I did not wish for what has befallen me. I can't help it. That's why I won't let myself be killed for it. Maybe we will meet again one day. Farewell, and look after yourself, Geralda. You put the letter into your pocket pensively. She has escaped. As night falls, you find yourselves on a hot mountain face covered in sharp crags. You would favour pretty much anywhere else to spend the night, but it is too dark to go any further. You are woken in the middle of the night by Boindel.
Scholar, can you smell it? There are piggies nearby.
You sniff deeply, but don't smell anything but the stench of sulphur. But you do see something moving in the shadows and are immediately wide awake. What is it?
Huh? On my way.
Yeah? Yeah, why not? What is it?
Feel my power!
Prepare yourself!
Yes?
What is it? Yeah! Of course!
Huh? At once!
What is it?
On my way.
Yeah?
This
taste
is going
my
to
hammer! Blech. Disgusting!
Huh?
And what now? Come here, you!
Chance. And I didn't even take off my gloves.
Huh? Understood.
He hardly put up a fight.
What is it?
Yes, yes. So, who's next? A bit too much for you, was I?
Yes.
Now you've got me interested.
Yeah. Let's go.
And what now?
Yeah. Prepare yourself!
Huh?
Yes, yes!
Huh?
He actually put up a fight!
Don't take
now
it
you've
personally!
Got
huh?
Yeah!
Huh?
What now?
What's up?
Huh?
Huzzah!
I'm with you!
Hmm?
What is it?
Yes?
Yeah!
Uh-huh.
Not a bad idea.
And
if
what?
I have to.
Attack! What is it? Come here, you!
What a waste of time.
Huh?
Yeah, why not?
Of course!
Huh? I can't do that yet.
End it.
Yeah!
Attack!
Yeah!
End it.
Now you've got me interested. This is going to hurt.
Yes?
Attack!
Vile creature.
End it.
And what now?
Yes,
yeah,
yes.
Why not?
I'm with you.
What is it? Now you've got me interested.
Huh?
What is it? Not a bad idea.
Huh? And again.
What is it?
Of course!
What's up?
And what now?
Of course!
Huh? Understood.
What is it?
And I didn't even take off my gloves.
Huzzah!
Come here, you!
What is it?
Huh? For Vrakus!
And what now?
Now you've got me interested. If I have to.
What's up?
Yeah, why not?
Huh?
Of course! I'm with you!
Yes?
What is it? All right,
yeah.
Then.
Huh?
Yeah!
On my way. Yes? At once.
Yeah!
No chance.
Understood.
Attack!
Now you've got me interested.
He won't last
what is
long.
It?
What a waste of time.
And what now?
I'm with you.
What is it?
Huh?
End it!
Don't take it personally!
What is it?
Yeah! Prepare yourself!
Yes? At once. Understood.
He hardly put up a fight.
And I didn't even take off my gloves. Now you've got me interested.
Yes?
Hmm? With pleasure.
Yeah? He won't last long. Huh? Disgusting.
What is it?
What is it?
Yes, at once.
After the battle, you finally have time to catch your breath. You check the others one by one to see how they are. Bavrigor seems out of it and is staggering with every step he takes.
Bavrigor, are you all right?
Agonizingly slowly, he turns to face you. Blood is flowing from his mouth and through his beard.
I made a mistake.
All strength slips from his body and he falls forward. An arrow is protruding from his back.
Andekai, Bavrigor has been hit!
You immediately rush towards him. Balandis, next to you, takes his hand.
Too late. The arrow was poisoned. I can feel it. I hadn't planned to return to the kingdom of the Secondlings. But I did at least want to complete my task to die in glory.
You won't die, Bavrigor. Andekai, can't you?
You turn to the Maegar, but one look at her face robs you of all hope. She shakes her head imperceptibly.
We are in the perished land, aren't we? Let me die. Then I can at least complete my task. My defiance will be stronger than the urge to do evil.
Before you can object, Boindil lays a hand on your shoulder.
You know yourself how stubborn we are, scholar. We should grant him his wish. If he turns on us, then I will take care of him myself.
You've heard about dead dwarves on expeditions in the Perished Land defying the bloodlust for many days. But you want to find a better way. Bavrigor's breathing is becoming shallower, until it finally stops completely. While Balandis is still sobbing next to you, the stonemason rises suddenly. His face is pale and his eyes seem empty.
Even death can't stop me. I told you, my defiance is stronger.
None of you really know what to say, and finally Bavrigor compels you to continue your journey. You can see the inner conflict in the stonemason's face, and you don't know how long he can resist it. You continue on your way with an uneasy feeling. Bavrigor has assured you that everything is all right, but since he came back, he has kept himself apart from the rest of the group. You decide to talk to him during your hike.
Are you really all right?
I feel nothing, Tongdil. I don't feel my body anymore, and my head is strangely empty. I ate things that I used to love, and things that I hated.
He glances at Boindil.
I would like to rip into shreds and devour.
You had no idea that it is so bad. On one hand, you feel an unspeakable pain seeing your companion in this state. On the other hand, you are afraid that he could attack one of you. And you hate being so afraid of Bavrigor.
Hey, Mega, tell your henchman he shall look after me. If I do things I shouldn't do, he is to stop me.
Everyone has stopped in their tracks and are all staring at the stonemason. Andakai is the first to free herself from the tense torpor, and with a nod, Jeroen follows the orders, and from that point he doesn't leave Bavrigor's side. You finally reach the place where Keenfire will take on form, the stronghold of the Fifthlings with the hottest forge in Girdlegard, Dragonfire. This is where evil first entered Girdlegard, a disgrace for the dwarves, who were given the task of protecting it by Varrakis. Since then, the Perish Land has spread. Alfar and orcs have invaded, and the elves almost eradicated. But you have decided to face up to the evil. You will forge Keenfire and stop Nodon, or die trying. You enter the old stronghold with determination.
Fifthlings really knew how to build a stronghold!
And we're probably the first dwarves in 1,000 cycles to enter these halls.
Come on, you beasts! I may be the last, but I will take at least 4 dozen more of you down with me!
Gundagar! Hold on, my king!
Oh, there's a surprise! Is there some courage hidden inside the little gem cutter after all?
Come on, let's help Gundagar.
Is it something bad?
Hmm?
And what now?
Of course!
Huh? Understood.
Yes?
What is it? If I have to.
What is it?
Yes?
Is it something bad?
Oh! You weren't expecting that, were you?
Oh, is that a good idea?
Huh?
What do you want me to do?
Yes?
Is it something bad?
Now you've got me interested. All right, then.
Huh?
What is it?
Kill!
What is it? Not a bad idea. If I have to. Interested.
What is it?
Yes? To do.
Kill.
Feel my power with pleasure.
Huh?
Come here, you.
And again. Turtle guy. Yes?
Yes?
Now you've got me
what
interested.
For Vrakus!
Yeah!
What a waste of time.
Is it something bad?
If I have to. All right, then.
My king, you're alive. Oh.
Tongdel. I would have never have thought I'd be so happy to see you again. You seem to have fared better than we.
What happened to you? Where are the others?
They are dead. Only I remain.
Your learned tongue refuses to do its job. You consider how it was you who sent these people to their ruin. You don't see any accusation in Gandagar's expression, just grief and determination.
And now that you are here, I carry the hope that their sacrifice was not in vain.
In a few short words, you give account of everything that has happened to you on your way to the kingdom of the Fifthlings. Gandagar listens silently and nods now and then.
You have done well. You appear to be a better leader than I expected, Tongdil Goldhand.
I don't know. Half the time I was advised what to do next.
It is our destiny to follow the untrodden path. Leaders take one step after the other. They never stand still. And if you look back and ask yourself, what if, you will never find the courage to take another step.
We have to get to the forge. Let's forget our contest and work together.
I agree. We have seen the spread of the Perished Lands, and the Beasts of Teon wanted us to keep away from this place. Maybe there is some truth in your story about Keenfire.
You tense your shoulders and strengthen the grip on your weapon.
Let's find out.
Not so fast, groundlings.
Are you going to stop us, little man?
Even greater armies haven't been able to stop us.
An evil grin spreads across the famulus's face.
Oh, I know. But how about this?
Finally, a real challenge! Everyone else, keep your hands off it! Understood?
What is it?
He won't last long.
Yes? At once.
Yes? I'm on my way.
Huh? On my way.
What is it?
Now you've got me interested.
Taste my hammer!
Well? Why not?
Yes? Understood.
He won't last long.
Vile creature. What is it?
On my way.
Attack!
Please wait a moment.
Well?
What is it?
Taste my hammer!
What the game won't last long.
What is it? Well?
Huh?
And I didn't even take off my gloves. Now you've got me interested.
What is it?
Huh?
What is it?
Yeah, why not?
Well?
Now you've got me interested.
Yes? Why not?
And I didn't even take off my gloves. Feel my power!
What is it?
They're all here!
I'm on it.
Huh?
Yeah!
Now you've got me interested.
Taste my hammer!
How many is that now?
Target in sight.
And again!
Yes?
Yeah!
Now you've got me interested.
He won't last long.
Welcome to the future!
I'm on it.
Huh?
What is it?
End it!
Yes?
Understood.
No chance.
And
a victory for technology!
And I didn't even take off my gloves.
There's a bit too many over here!
Yes?
What is it?
Now you've got me interested.
Prepare yourself!
What is it? Yes? What is it? Why not?
Fire creature!
What is it?
Yes?
And again!
Why not?
What's up?
Vile creature!
Taste my hammer!
What is it?
Target in sight!
Now you've got me interested. All right, then. If I have to.
Vile creature!
He won't last long.
I'm on my way.
What's up?
What is it? Why not? Yes? Well?
Prepare yourself!
Yes? All right then.
A victory for technology!
What is it? waste of time. With pleasure.
Sure. Well? Target in sight.
Yes?
Yeah!
Now you've got me interested.
What is it? I'm on it.
What is it?
Welcome to the future!
Huh? At what? For Vrakus! And again! End it!
Well?
Now you've got me interested.
A victory for technology!
Waste of time.
Well,
On my way.
Now you've got me interested.
What's up?
What is it?
Yes.
Understood.
I didn't even take off my gloves. What is it? Magic takes time.
Yes?
Huh? On my way.
Now you've got me interested. All right, then.
Yes?
Understood.
Not a bad idea.
Well?
What is it?
Yes?
What's up?
Yes. Why not?
Disgust me.
No chance.
All
right, then. Not a bad idea. Now you've got me interested.
Yes?
Not a bad idea.
What is it? A victory for technology!
A bit too much for you, was I?
Yes.
Vile creature.
I'm on it. How many is that now?
Now you've got me interested.
What's up?
What is it? Attack!
No chance.
Hey! Did you
get it over there? I didn't take off my gloves.
What's up?
Yes?
No chance.
Looking for a while.
Welcome to the future.
You.
Why not?
Yes?
Taste my hammer!
What is it?
And again.
Now you've got me interested.
Yes?
Understood. I won't.
Now you've got
I'm pretty much on my limit over here.
Interested.
Come here, you!
What is it?
What is it?
What is it? Not a bad idea. if I have to. Not a bad idea.
Yeah.
Now you've got me interested. If I have to.
Yes?
Huh? Yes, yes!
Uh-huh.
No chance. Of course!
Hmm?
Huh? I'm with you!
Yeah?
Huh?
Yeah! And what now?
What a waste of time.
Come here, you!
What? I'm on it.
Now you've got me interested. Good night. No chances.
Attack!
Understood.
Huh?
What is it?
Yeah?
Huh?
Yeah! Ow! Hey! What is it?
Now you've got me interested.
What? Fine.
I have Boenda!
What a
give me a
time.
Hand!
I can't do that yet.
I have Boenda!
In
give
a moment!
Me a hand.
I can't do that yet. I'm on it.
Yes?
What is it? You've got me interested.
Hmm? At once.
What is it?
Too
I can't even
many
take off my gloves.
Enemies.
Magic takes time.
Die. Yeah?
What is it?
Uh-huh.
On my way.
Hmm?
Yes?
Yes! Ow! Hey!
Too many enemies!
Huh? Hmm? Now you've got me interested.
And what now?
Yeah?
And I didn't even take off my gloves.
Uh-huh.
What a waste of time.
Huh?
Hmm? This is going to hurt.
What?
Now you've got me interested.
Huh?
What is it? All right then.
Yeah? Already done it.
Yeah!
What? I need some help. Time.
Shh. On my way.
Huh?
Now you've got
and
me
what
interested.
And what now? Yeah. Who's next?
Hmm? Hmm? My gloves.
Enemies.
With pleasure. No chance.
Huh?
Yeah!
Tungdil, let's hope that was the last obstacle on the path to your victory.
I've already said it once, but I will say it again. I don't want the throne, and I never did. All I care about is saving Girdlegard. If I don't manage, make sure that Keenfire is forged, and promise me that you will work with Namora and Keenfire against Nodon.
Gandagar bows his head.
By Vrakas and Giselbert Ironeye, in whose kingdom we now stand, I swear I will not rest until Nodon is dead. But you will be by my side.
Can't be serious.
It looks like all the fiends of Girdlegard have gathered here together.
You take a deep breath.
We've come too far to give up now. The gate to the forge is at the other end of the hall. Protect those who are important for the creation of the Keenfire. The rest of us are dispensable. Attack!
Ah!
For Girdlegard!
For Vrakas! Yeah, I'm going! Here I come!
Now you've got me interested.
Yes? Right. Come on!
Uh-huh. Understood. End it!
What is it?
At your service. Ah, I understand.
Yes?
Die?
Well?
Now you've got me interested. Feel my power!
And
I didn't even take off my gloves.
Come on!
Huh?
Girdle guard is ours! Yes?
Yes?
If I have to.
All right, your then. Demise was inevitable. At your service.
Huh?
What is it? What a waste of time.
Well, agree. No one can stop me.
With pleasure.
Die?
Yes.
What is it?
Another victory!
This is going to hurt.
All right, then.
Now you've got me interested. Feel my power!
Kill!
No chance.
Well? Come on!
At your service.
Huh?
What a waste of time.
Vile
creature! Yes?
Huh?
Excellent choice!
Hope dies with me. What is it?
Yes.
At your service.
Agreed.
Now you've got me interested.
Die?
Huh?
Attack!
What is it?
Well?
Oh.
Yes?
On my way.
Your demise was inevitable.
Kill.
Another victory!
Girdle guard is ours!
Now you've got me interested.
At your service.
Yes?
What is it?
Well? Come on! Meet your doom! No one can stop me!
Die?
Huh?
Your demise was inevitable. At your service?
Hmm?
Come on!
Vile creature!
For Vrakas!
What is it?
Yes?
Another victory!
Meet your doom!
And again!
All right, then.
What is it? My gloves.
At your service.
Yes,
at right.
Once. Huh? Understood.
Now you've got me interested. Not a bad idea.
Well?
Yes.
Yes.
No chance.
For Vrakas.
What is it?
Well fought.
And again. Vile creature.
Now you've got me interested.
No one can stop me. Just die.
If I have to.
Huh? Understood.
Yeah!
What is it?
Yes. All right, then. Agreed. Right.
All right,
then.
At your service. I understand. Excellent choice. I understand. Die. At your service. Over there.
Now you've got me interested. And I didn't even take off my gloves. All right, then.
Huh?
Excellent choice. Over there.
Glad.
I understand. Over there.
Glad.
I understand.
Understood.
What is it? If I have to.
Another victory!
What a waste of time.
Well?
Oh!
Yes?
For Vrakus!
Hmm? Right. All right, then.
And again!
I?
Huh?
At your service.
Huh?
Now you've got me interested. If I have to.
Well? No one can stop me!
Huh?
Please wait a moment!
Vile creature!
Understood.
Not a bad idea.
Meet your doom!
Huh? On my way. Understood.
And I didn't even take off my gloves.
Agreed.
What is it?
Huh?
Yeah!
Yes. Right.
Not a bad idea.
Friends! I can do this!
Huh? On my way.
Yeah!
What is it? With pleasure.
Yes. Well?
I didn't even take off my gloves.
Come on!
Die?
Huh? Understood. End it!
Just die!
At your service?
Oh. Yes? At what?
Yeah!
Huh? Huh? On my way.
Die?
Huh?
Now you've got me interested. All right, then.
Huh? Understood.
What is it? If I have to.
Girdle Guard is ours! Yes? All right, then. Right. Here, I need support! All right, then. Right.
Now you've got me interested. What a waste of time.
Agreed.
Not a bad idea. Feel my power. With pleasure. All right then. No chance. If I have to. All right, then. If I have to.
Yes.
On my way.
Glad.
Excellent choice. On my way.
I understand.
Understood.
Over there.
Glad.
Yes?
At once.
I understand. What is it? If I have to. Not a bad idea.
Well. Agreed.
Huh?
It won't open!
Time for a plan, scholar! Enough! The time has come!
Not on.
Open the gate. I'll hold him off for as long as I can.
Back, you maggots! They belong to me!
That isn't Nodon. It's...
Redaria.
It makes no difference. The gate is bolted shut.
Leto, get inside!
You recognize the dwarf standing in front of you in shimmering armor, because you have seen his features more than once, wrought in gold and vracassium and flaunted on the walls on your way through the kingdom of the Fifthlings. Giselbert Ironei, the progenitor of the Fifthlings.
Welcome, whoever you may be. I hope your coming is a good omen.
You look at the 10 dwarves with their pale faces and eyes that seem slightly vacant, as if they were in a trance. They are wearing wonderfully crafted armor, and the resolve that Vrakas gave his people can be read in each and every face.
It really is you, isn't it?
We are the last of the Fifthling clan. We have defied the hordes of evil since the downfall of my realm. We fell against the Elfar and were brought back to life by the Perished Land. But instead of serving it, we fought against it. We are rather hard to defeat, and each of my men has slain more monsters than any other dwarf before them. But such victories are a meager consolation after such a loss.
And you don't feel any hate towards other dwarves or all things living?
You are thankful for the old king and his men. But you experience firsthand what power the Perished Land exerts over those it has in its grasp.
We have learned. 1,100 cycles have been enough to silence the hate inside us.
You look at the legendary king's face and see no signs of lying, but also no joy, no hope, no life. Just sadness and the irrepressible defiance of the dwarves.
I thank you for your help. Without you, we would have been finished.
Those creatures were content to just watch us for an age, but for the last few orbits, they have been trying to take the forge. I dare say the change has something to do with your wee band, eh?
We are representatives of the Firstlings, the Secondlings, and the Fourthlings, accompanied by the Maegar, Andekai, the Tempestuous, and friends. It's grim for Girdlegard. The magical barriers that kept the Perished Land in check for centuries are destroyed. A Magus by the name of Nod On controls the magic, and he can't be killed. Not with any ordinary weapon.
The Dragonfire Forge. Can we light it?
No.
But it's the only place where we can forge Keenfire. The only weapon that can defeat Nod On.
The furnace cannot be lit because it never went out. We defended it against invaders from the beginning. It is burning as hot and bright as ever. Vrakas must have known we would need it again one day. Now, rest. The gates will not fall. We'll see to that. Permit yourselves as much sleep as you need, and then we will get to work.